Good morning. This morning I'm going to cover the application called Fortune Cookie, and we're going to be able to convert this Fortune Cookie application to use a QTimer. And so I'm going to first start and show you the plain Fortune Cookie, and then we'll convert it to a QTimer. Use a QTimer. So QTimers are talked about on page 321 in chapter 9, and this is from the prescribed textbook, An Introduction to Design Patterns in C++ with QT, the second edition. You can find further information on QTimer at the following two locations. That'll be the documents, and the one is for QT6 and the other one's for QT5, because I believe QT4 has reached end of life. It is inherited from QDialog, requires the QMake setting of QT plus widgets, and is also requires the include QTimer header function. Okay, and so this is what our project file is going to look like once we create it. Okay. So without further ado, let's get started. So first we open our QT program, then we click on new project, okay? And since we want applications, I'm going to make it a QWidget applications. I'm going to say choose. Okay, the folder that I want to put it in is my Unisa folder. So this is where I want it. Okay, and the project that I'm going to call it is, I'm going to call it Fortune Cookie, just like that. All right, and I'm going to say next. I'm happy to use QT 5.3.0, the MinGW 32-bit. And for the class name, I'm going to create this as Fortune Cookie. And I'm going to make it a base class of QDialog, and so you'll see it'll include the header and the source file, but I don't want it to generate a form. I want it to be automatic. Okay, so let's click on next, and those are the, you can see the four files are going to be created. Click on finish. Okay, we then get presented with this screen, and if we go and we inspect our header, you'll see our header's got our fortune cookie, include QDialog, we've got a QObject option, then we've got our fortune cookie, that's our default constructor, and then this is a destructor. So I'm going to take out the destructor because I don't really want that for now. Alright. And then, I seem to be making a few errors here. Just want to, haven't used this keyboard in a while. So on my program, I'm gonna just want a default constructor, and then I want to have a button. So the button's going to need a signal and slot, and so we've got to define our button here. The way we define our button is to say a public slots. So we go here, public slots, like that. Okay, and then our button is going to be called, we're going to create a void function, a void function called show fortune. Okay. And then what we're going to do is we're going to have a private variable called messages. Okay, private, and we're going to say a queue string. string list, and that's going to be messages. Okay, so that is our header defined. I'm going to actually take out this part over here. I don't want this in it. Okay. We're next going to go to our source file, and then we're going to amend our source file. So let's go and do that. And for our source file, there's a few options that we're going to import. So one of the things that we're going to import is a Q push button. So we just go hash include and our Q push button. Okay. The next thing we also want to include is a Q VBox layout. So this is our layout option. Q VBox layout. And another one is a Q message box. So include Q message box. Alright. Then we've got that. For this, as I said, I'm going to take this part out. Don't want that, and I'm not going to need this part either. Okay, for our starting of our definition, we're going to use our messages queue string list, which we've already defined. So we're going to say messages, and we're going to have express yourself. Don't hold back. Okay, the next one was for success today, look first at yourself. And then the last message, third message, is whenever possible, keep it simple. Okay, so these are three messages that will be selected in order to display, and those three messages will appear randomly. Alright, so the next part, what we're going to do is we're going to start building our fortune cookie app. Okay, and so we first need our Q push button. All right and we're declaring that as PB, and we're saying a new Q push button. I'm just going to copy and paste it. Okay, and we're going to have our button reflect open a fortune cookie. Fortune cookie. Okay. We're then going to define our Q box layout. QV box layout. Okay. And we're defining that as our layout. New. And we want this. Okay, and now we're going to add our widget to our layout. So we do that by saying layout, add widget, and we say our PB, which is our push button. Okay, and then finally we're saying this, and we want to display or set our layout. Add our layout, set layout, and we say layout. Alright, the next thing what we want to do is we want to create a push button. So our push button is called, we're going to say connect, and we're going to say connect our push button as a signal, and we're calling the default timeout. Okay, and then we are assigning it to this, and we're using a slot of show fortune cookie. Show fortune. Okay, that's that, and we add one more bracket and we close. So now that will create our form and show our push button. As mentioned, I'm taking out the destructor, and as you've seen over here, we've just got this, and we've also got our show fortune, okay, which is our public slot. So now we want to create that over here, and so we can define our function show fortune. Alright, and that's going to be a QString, and we're going to show our message equals messages. It's going to select it randomly, and then we've got 3, and then we're going to pass it to a QMessageBox to display this. QMessageBox information, this message, and our message M, which was assigned above. Okay, and that should be it, if I'm not mistaken. Should be okay for that. Let's go and test it out. We want to definitely save all. Okay, identified an issue, and this was that this ending bracket and the semicolon was missing, and also for this I saw the void was missing over here. But after that, I can now run the code, and let's execute, and it should run fine. So this is what I get when I'm presented. You can see there, fortune cookie is the app, and it says open a fortune cookie. So I click on it, and it should present me with a Q message box that shows me one of the messages. Okay, I think I got ahead of myself. This signal is supposed to be clicked, not timeout. So let's do that and run it. As I was saying, here's the app and the button. So when I click, you see there's a message, and you just keep clicking and it will randomly choose the messages. Okay, and so that's what this program does. And so now the next step of it is to create a queue timer and convert this from the clicked option to the queue timer option. So in order to do that, we have to specify that we want to include a queue timer here. Okay. And then we actually start adding the queue timing options here. Alright, so first of all, what we do is, I'm going to take this out. I'm just commenting this line out because we're going to reuse it, but with an amendment. So we first define a new instance. So I'm actually going to label it. I'm going to say here, create a new instance this QTama object, and assign it to this. So we say QTama, and the object name that we're going to use is Tama, and we're going to say equals new QTama. Assigning it to this. Okay, then the next thing that we're going to do is we're going to connect it. So I'm just going to add this comment. We then add our timer object to the signal and slot. So in order to do that, like I said, we'll just copy most of this code. PV, but this clicked was timeout, but it was meant for only for the queue timer. So we leave the rest the same, okay? And then we're gonna use the start function and provide a time argument. Milliseconds, and 1,000 milliseconds is going to equal 1 second. So I'm going to use a 5 second timer. So we say timer, and we're going to say the start function, and we want it to start after 5 seconds. And so that's all that is required to convert this to a timer. So let's execute it. So here we have our program, and it should present a message in the next 5 seconds if I have entered everything correctly. Okay, the reason it's not working is because we haven't set, instead of assigning our push button, we needed to assign this new timer to it. So let's go and do that. Now we should be good. And now you can see the button gets it automatically times, and it sends a message every 5 seconds without any buttons being pushed or anything. Alright, thank you for watching. I hope this video has been helpful and informative, and all the best with COS 2614. Thanks and goodbye.